I was born in Izmir in Turkey. Until 7 years old, we lived in that city. But once my grandfather and grandmother got sick and they were living in village, my father had to make a decision to go back to village. But my mom asked for one thing from my dad. She said that I want my all children to go to a school in town. She wanted all of us to be successful for our education and everything. When I was 8, I realized that I want to be part of the big world and I wanted to be part of this global industry. And I told myself that I'm going to be a professor. And that was the first time I told myself that that was my dream, that I said, okay, this is going to be something, I'm going to make it. I was the oldest one. That's why I started my education as a Bachelor of Science in Naval Academy, because during that time, Naval Academy was free. I didn't want my father struggle for my brothers and sisters. I served for more than 15 years. I did my master's in United States Naval Engineering Program at MIT. And then I came to Blacksburg to finalize my PhD here. We are looking for actually when a ship could have a torpedo attack or an anti-surface missile attack, then you need to understand if the remaining compartments and remaining systems that you have on board are enough for you to go back to your port. And this is one of the aspects we are looking for right now. Virginia Tech has a lot of resources. All students right now, my advice would be try to understand what resources you have and use them. In order to achieve your dreams and achieve your degree, whatever you are looking for. We have a pool here. Whenever I had problems, my research, I got stuck, I channeled my anxiety and also all my negative aspects to the water. I had moments like I was giving up, like, you know, before preliminary exam, before my pre-defense. It was really tough. I have a family. I have a 7-year-old son and I have my wife. They have been so supportive. My son was 6 months old when I started Virginia Tech. So she has been taking good care of my son when I was doing long nights after my job and I felt, you know, exhausted, but she was just being supportive. Sometimes you just need some person who is looking into your eyes and telling you that you're gonna make it. That's the only thing you needed. And she has never lost the faith in me. And I think that's the most important thing. My literature teacher, she was my like my second mom. She has always told me, if you're going to be on the top of the mountain, if you have not brought anyone with you, that's not success. The success is if you are there with the community that you have built and with the friends and the support that you did, that's what matters.